was slapping now. That was slapping. Yeah, you know what I'm about. You know, I love the bass. You know what I'm saying? That dude was slapping.
That's
like,
your homie.
Yo.
Yeah, that's your homie.
Oh, my God,
every nigga
was slapping. I'm bro. That. Yeah, and I got to put that on the playlist.
Yeah, that big rock dog. Bro, every nigga I let. Every nigga I let hear that song, bro, be like, man, who the fuck that is, bro? I don't know what it is about that song, bro. I'm not going to lie to you, Phil. I done had to repeat that bitch for like about five niggas before, son. You're like, man, play that bitch again, man. I'm like, hi.
That bitch, that's slap. I'm telling you, I heard that song before.
Yeah, that walking good boy, that popping. Yeah, that popping go. Oh,
that's a pull up song. You pull up to the club on that. You feel me?
somebody played an instrumental earlier. I'm about to get in my instrumental bag, but I'm like, nah, niggas really not ready.
Yeah, that was a mishap. That was actually a song. I don't know what happened.
That instrumental bag, but it has y'all here chilling, smoking. Y'all
give me 1 second.
I'm telling you, I would have happened that, bro. I'm like, yo, nah. These niggas gonna be too geeked.
That was supposed to be a song. I don't know what happened. I guess that song ain't clear.
It's still a fire beat though. I was like, oh
yeah, it was a fire. Look, that's why I play. That's why I played it because the beat is fire.
I was like, oh, this beat kind of hard.
That's why I played it, bro. I'm like, see, I thought the beat was kind of hard, and I thought the brother was kind of rapping on the wrong nigga, bitch. No lyrics. So,
Cujo, you there, bro? I don't know if you muted up. I was listening to, you put me on that Uno Activist Limbus 3, but I really think that Limbus 2.5 might be better, bro. I really do, because, like, they both fire, but I'm just like, I'm listening to that 2.5 more now. I went back on the go back, and I'm like, I feel like I kind of like that one a little bit better. I don't know. One's a little more hype, the other one a little more, is on a smoother side. So I don't know. I like that 2.5 a little bit better, though. But then, like, he dropped so much shit last year. I didn't even know. Like, he dropped, like, probably, like, four projects. He had a double project with this one dude. Then he had, like, yeah, he be dropping a lot of shit when he dropped, man. Like he dropped four projects. That Extendo song, I got the funny story about that song, that's my song right there, but I got some head to that song before. I ain't gonna lie, that Extendo song.
Jesus Christ, bro.
Bro, I want to know where y'all get all y'all new music from. Like, do y'all? Cause I go to this little YouTube channel. They just play like the latest music, and I hear songs on there. So that's how I can get my music. So what do y'all?
I use SoundCloud. Yeah, they got the albums on there, but SoundCloud they got a lot of artists on there and producers and shit because. You can just put music on there and shit like that, you know. So that's where a lot of people be coming up from. That's how Lil Pump guy, you know, he used to be a SoundCloud rapper and shit. So,
is this a random playlist on there? Like this is random people playing?
SoundCloud, let's say if you listen to something, Lucci, let's say if you listen to one of your favorite songs, right? And then it's over with. And then it goes to, play a next song. Just play a next song for you. Sometimes that shit, they be like, it be cooking too. You like what the
yeah,
fuck?
Yeah, yeah, it be cooking.
My light list is long as hell. My light list is. I'm like, damn, man. Like, so like you can like it and save it and shit. So yeah, SoundCloud cool. I like it. Actually, I like SoundCloud better than Spotify. To be honest with y'all, I used to have Tidal. Used to have all three of them hoes. But, like,
do Spotify play the new music? Do Spotify play the new music?
Do they play the shit you gonna hear in the streets?
Go ahead, Phil.
You kind of really need all three for real, cause certain shit like Spotify has shit, SoundCloud
it's a
don't
commercial.
Have, SoundCloud has shit, Spotify don't have, but then Tidal has
pirate at that. Like, at that point, I'm just pirate, bro.
I'm cool with that though. I'm cool with that because I'm not. Really,
if you get
like,
YouTube Music, actually, you get it. At whatever it is, you can play it.
I'll play it.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, YouTube music might not have everything in there. It's been I had that too, and sometimes they ain't have a mixtape.
Nah, that's a problem. That's a problem.
When it comes to
I use Spotify. I use Spotify for more than just music. I use it for like podcasts too. So I pay for I have Spotify Premium. Yeah. Right? So I pay my $10.99 a month.
I don't see you boosting.
And I use it. What you talking about?
Does it give you access to every album, every artist, every album they ever drop, Phil? When you deal with
Some stuff will be there, and then if you're taking off, but you don't know why.
Yeah, okay.
That's when you gotta.
That's how it is on Apple too.
I don't be concerned about that because I already have my liked music. Yeah. I got over 1,300 songs on my liked songs.
Okay.
Me too. Like, it's the same thing with SoundCloud. Okay. Like, SoundCloud got hella 90s music too. Like, you know what I'm saying? But they ain't gonna have everything. Like,
So to your point, Lucci, without what Spotify does is kind of like what Body Bags was just saying. They have a Discover Weekly and a Release Radar playlist that's like made for me based off the shit that I listen to now. Right. So I'll take time out to listen to those two playlists all the way through. And I'll pick out the songs that I like.
Okay.
And I'll dismiss the songs that I don't like, right? So that's how I get caught up on new artists or artists that I already like already. That they drop new shit and how I kind of roll with that. And I just keep adding to my like playlist.
Yeah.
Phil, there's because I know SoundCloud at the end of the year, it'll give you everything that you pretty much listen to. Pretty much that year, like let's say in 2019, I had like a lot of DaBaby songs and a lot of Glock 9, Florida Niggas, and they'd be like, "This is your playlist for this year for 2019. This is what you
want." Damn, they didn't give you a whole playlist from 2019.
I got that on my my shit start from like 2017. My shit got like 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020, 2021.
Oh, you've been a Spotify
Yeah, I was on Spotify early because as soon as it came out, I was kind of like, this is the, you know what I'm saying? This is the wave right here. This is where all the music is going. But, you know, Apple Music, you know, everybody else. But, you know, I'm just used to Spotify. I've just been navigating it for so long. You know? Like, me with Xbox.
Right.
Me with Xbox. Like, I don't really consider, I can't say I'm going to just go to buy a PlayStation 5. I'm really Xbox.
Oh, you're an Xbox now.
I was going to get Xbox. I would want to get Xbox.
See, I used to listen to Spotify. It was like the radio shows. It was like in 2010 to 2013, I think. But I just used to put on a radio station and let it play. I didn't know that I can.
Apple Music has changed.
You think Apple is trash? Bro, I'm not going to lie about it, man. Yeah, I don't know how I would be able to live without that, bro. I think Apple has been, for the last six years, it's been convenient.
To buy music, though.
It's been convenient.
It's been to buy music,
No. Hold up, Phil. You don't buy music on Apple. You pay your $9.99 and you can just listen to anything at any time whenever you want. That's why I asked, do Spotify have that? Because Apple, you just, you know, every album, whatever.
That's a little older and like not that many people listen to it anymore. You can't really find it on streaming services. So that's why I fucking pirate. And I tell everyone to pirate.
Nah, you got my computer over y'all with all kind of viruses over y'all talking about fucking virus.
I listen to Rick James the other day. I just listened to Chaka Khan probably 2 hours ago.
On YouTube?
That's Spotify. Not obscure, Phil. That's not obscure, though.
But I'm saying that's old music, though.
No, but that's not obscure old music.
Hold up, so Marabi, what you do? You just go on pirate and
download
albums?
What you talking about? Like, there's Beethoven on Spotify. How old you want to go back?
There's random punk albums that are not on. I can't think of off the top of my head, but that's the genre that stands out where they don't have like all
they
the
weren't
music.
Powerful enough for I'd be sorry.
Oh,
sorry.
Nah.
See, this is what I'm talking
well,
about.
Well, what would you hold on, what would you say, Phil, like when you see an artist have a song or album on, let's say, on one of these streaming platforms, and then you see them that you can't access that album? What do you think goes on behind the scenes with that situation?
I don't know, I know on SoundCloud when I listen to Wu-Tang, Winter Wars is not, you can't play Winter Wars. You can't really play that anywhere. I'm like, what the fuck? Why can I not play Winter Wars? Bro, like, I couldn't, on Spotify, I'm not sure if I can play Winter Wars. Like, it was just weird. I don't know what people want
to listen to Blueprint all the time, but I can't listen to the Blueprint anymore. I have to pirate it.
No, Blueprint is on SoundCloud. They got all Jay-Z
Blueprint.
Wait,
what?
Marab, you got an iPhone? If you pay for it on SoundCloud and Spotify, they got the catalogs of these niggas' music. On
yeah.
The older 90s.
Yeah, it's on there.
But I would suggest if a nigga have an iPhone, bro, you should have Apple Music, though. If you have an iPhone, I would think you should have Apple.
I've had a Jay-Z night at the crib. Yeah, I Jay-Z music through Spotify. It's all on there.
Even
album with him and Beyonce, like that's on there too.
I don't know if you, this artist from Brooklyn, Kujo. His name is Nas Blicky, but he put out an album, and then 2 weeks later, he didn't pay for it to be up, so it came down again.
That's on him.
So it's also
I've seen regular songs, bro. Like how? Like what do y'all think goes on behind the scenes? Is that something dealing with the label? Is that something dealing with the artist? Like
just him not paying.
I don't know.
Oh, so they not paying? Like I'm gonna say this. I seen a Kevin Gates and Lil Kim song. That you know, my girl, like it's always been on Apple Music. Hold up, that we're gonna get to him on Sophisticated Sippers. That's why we got the golden. No, hold up, bro. Let's go. Let's just finish this. I got a Kevin Gates and Lil Kim song, but I was trying to figure out. I know I'm talking about next week, Sophisticated Sipper, next Friday. I was trying to figure out, like, why was this song pulled down? Like, you know, it's Kevin Gates and it's Lil Kim, like. I'm trying to figure out, like, all the other shit is up there. So why was this shit? Like, what went on behind the scenes?
It'd be the labels and it'd probably be the art. It'd be other shit. Because, like on SoundCloud, Joy Badass, all his albums ain't on there. It's certain albums, like, you kind of got type. See, this was only really on SoundCloud. If the album ain't on there, somebody else gonna post it. But it could get deleted, though. Because somebody like, damn, why you post this on here? Because
or if they don't have a sample. If the song it has a sample base on it and the sample hasn't cleared yet, so they can't post it. They can't post it on streaming services to garner money from it, right? Because you're going to get money every time the song is streamed. So if the sample hasn't cleared yet through the lawyers and all the powers that be, you can't really put it up there. So that's why some songs will get taken down. Mm-hmm.
The powers that be?
I'm not sure.
Yeah. I'm starting with the label.
Yeah. That, okay.
Like SoundCloud, I don't know about Spotify, but like, I know some platforms I've seen, like, they ain't have Reasonable Doubt on there. Sometimes you can't find that. I mean, on Tidal, that's Jay-Z's app. It might be. It's probably on there, but like,
on Tidal, it's exclusive. That and the Blueprint.
You probably got to have that premium on Tidal for that shit, see? Because Jay-Z, I'm not even sure if he's still even, that was one album he had to fight for the rights to even get to that. I'm not even sure if he got the rights for it.
I got Spotify Premium, man. I don't have a problem. I didn't know music, and I want to listen to shit that I like. Anything, like I find anything. It don't matter. Like I find it all. I play it all.
Can we get to the topics?
Mm-hmm. Oh wait, no, Kujo. We good. That was just the intro. Sorry about that. Yeah, we here. I got my microphone hooked up tonight, though. That's good.
I wasn't sure if you started or not. Yeah.
We good. Yeah. After the music, you know, the car button been here. That the real car button we hit like probably two or three songs before the music started.
Okay.
Yeah, man. We here, man. Mm-hmm. Another week, man. Izzy Pond Podcast. Finna get these topics. You know what I'm saying? Out the way, you know. Actually, one of these I wanted to do, but, you know what I'm saying, Brother Boom, by the way, you know what I'm saying, special shout out to the brother, man, happy birthday. You know what I'm saying? It's Brother Boone's birthday today, so, you know, he's out and about. But this topic really was specific to him, but since he ain't here, I'm going to wait. You know what I'm saying? Because I know that this is going to be one of them ones, so.
Was it the superhero shit?
Yeah, it was the Batman joint.
Yeah. We're going to wait on
Batman
him.
He's going to punch. He's ready. Right, he's going to have to. That's it. You know,
I'm gonna wait till folks really, you know what I'm saying, everybody here and shit, but
Kyle, we gotta wait on Kyle too,
because
Kyle brought it up.
We'll probably do it Wednesday. If I don't know if you can make it Wednesday for like a debrief episode or something like that. And we're gonna do a sophisticated sipping next Friday.
I'm
gonna just say that we got to do the sophisticated sip book because there's too much cringe been going on these last 20 days, bro. We gotta, Phil, just have your, you know what time it is.
We gonna do it. Look,
yeah, just go ahead. We're going to do it next Friday.
Yeah.
Next Friday. Just have whatever you need to have next to you. You got to make no store run. As road is,
this topic, man, I'm going to roll it out. Basically, you know, listen, man, everybody know, when you know, as a rapper, flow matters, man. It's not just about lyrics. You know what I'm saying? It's not just about how you put words together, anything. It's about, you know what I'm saying, the flow, man, the delivery. So I'm just going to talk about, you know, who y'all feel like overall got some of the best flows in hip-hop and some of the worst.
Everybody bags. So
that's basically the topic, man. Who got some of the best flows in hip-hop all time, and who got some of the worst all time. So,
okay.
You know what I'm saying? I already got one person in mind already about AZ got one of the best flows in hip hop history. Man, that dude, man, it's just the way he skated on the track, man, with the double time. Like, yeah, that shit be crazy, man. He got one of the best flows to me overall. I ain't never heard him, you know what I'm saying, to where it's like it's not listenable at all. Like,
I was just gonna say Nas got one of the best flows, like, you know, it sound effortless. Jeezy, if I can go south, Jeezy got an effortless flow. Like,
what about T.I., bro?
T.I. is my favorite rapper of all time. That's my favorite rapper, bro.
Wayne
and stuff.
T.I.
is my nigga.
Okay. I could see that, though, too. I can understand that, though. Bro.
Oh, that's not, I know somebody. Midwest legend, my nigga Common. And one of my favorite. I like Raekwon.
Common does have a dope flow.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Raekwon,
he sounds like he be talking but flowing at the same time with Common. Like, it's just, I don't know. It's just like he be talking, but.
What about Wale?
I know.
What about Wale? Wale.
Who's that artist that works with Alchemist a lot? He got that really smooth flow.
Odie James?
Yeah. No.
Not Baldy.
But he's a really established name. Rocky.
Smoke Dizza.
Rock Marciano?
Yeah, Rock.
Rock Marciano.
He named himself after a boxer? No, man, we not doing that. We not doing that, Sam.
Rock Marciano can actually
be
doing that.
Nah, bro, come on, man. You can't. Nah, bro. You nickname a nigga name. Like, nah, we not doing
you
that,
like
bro.
You like Rick Ross.
Nah, y'all do. Yeah, you right about that, but I don't like that. That didn't fit right in my spirit when you say it that. Go ahead.
How do y'all feel about Wiz and Currency? They're my two favorite. They're really like far as flow
Currency,
wise.
Currency guy.
I'm not gonna lie. I only like Christian Orange Juice, and that's it. But no, Currency, I like Currency a lot.
Marabi, go listen to Wiz got Wings. You like this because that's by Sledrin. That's
okay,
by Sledrin.
I'm gonna check
and,
it out.
Because like, the people that made Christian Orange Juice. Wiz got Wings came out in 2021, and it's made by the producers Sledger and Cardo.
Hey, Body Bags, wasn't that the last album? Wasn't that the last album that the last joint that he just dropped?
Yeah,
that's fire.
What was the mixtape with Harry Frog? What was that?
The one with Wiz?
Yeah, no, Currency and Harry Frog.
The one with the boat on it? That was
hard.
Yeah, that was fire.
Yeah, it was a classic.
That's amazing. I'm gonna say this. I respect Currency so much, bro, because it's a lot of times I talk to guys that's not from Louisiana, and before they mention Boosie, Gates, or all these other brothers, these brothers will mention Currency, bro, and a lot of times they will mention him before they mention Wayne, and I just like I got a totally different respect for that brother, dude, man.
You don't listen to?
Yo, I was listening to him when in like the mixtape era, when Wayne and him was in the mixtape era. You know, I was fucking with him during that time, but yeah. I'm gonna have to go back man. I just hear him on features and shit, though. Give me a banger from Currency.
Chopped and Screwed version of it. That Chopped and Screwed mixtape is crazy.
Give me a banger from Currency. Give me a banger. A banger. I need a banger.
Hold on. Let me do it.
Don't put it on. I just need to know the name.
I'm not gonna let it play long. I'm gonna stop it.
I got albums.
No, we can't play shit.
You can't play it. You can't play it at all. Cause it's gonna flag.
He said it's gonna flag.
A banger. Yeah,
we're not talking.
I'm gonna let it go for like 20 seconds.
They're
gonna steal flag, man. Cut it now.
Go listen to Dragon Feet by Currency, the Pilot Talk by Currency, the Pilot Talk series. I got so much Currency for Lucci, I can just send it to you. Like, listen, yeah. I'm gonna send it to you. I got hella Currency.
I've seen Currency live twice, Lucci. In Mobile. Yeah? I've seen Currency live twice. Yeah, I've seen Currency live twice here in Mobile. Every time, it's always been lit, and I was with niggas that was able to be around niggas that was with niggas.
Yeah.
You knew people who knew people.
Yeah, right.
So it's always been love when you come down here.
Y'all still on Best Flows?
How y'all put about Larry June?
Yeah.
Y'all ever heard of Larry June? Y'all know who that is? Larry June?
Yeah,
Larry June, dope.
See, Larry June and like Dom Kennedy, I kind of put them in the same boat. Like they got similar flow. Like they got that still that smooth flow. Y'all ever heard of Primo Rice?
Primo
got a real smooth flow.
But you know what's crazy about this whole conversation, bro?
For these little drill niggas, I like ESTG. I like his flow.
He's not a drill artist, bro. I see what you're saying.
You know what's crazy about this, bro? I haven't heard y'all mention anyone who's like mainstream, like, and that's what's fire about what I'm listening to right now. Like a lot of these names I don't know, but I've heard of some of these names, but it's nobody mainstream though. That and that's fire though. I like that.
I put Fuji Rap up there too. Fuji Rap got a very Fuji Rap. Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah.
Fuji Rap is fire. I like
Noriega. Cujo, who would you say from the 90s?
It's not laid back though. It's super aggressive, Cool G shit.
If you had to pick somebody,
it was very sporadic, man. Like it took me a while to really like digest
the niggas. Nori,
I don't know. When we go back and listen to CNN War Report, it's like that's a different Nori, like. The CNN network, Channel 10, it's on again. Street niggas is grown men. Ballface,
yeah, it was strong. Listen to
well. He was talking. Yeah, he was talking.
Before we go, I'm finna go to the worst clothes in a minute too, man.
Okay.
Hold on. Before you go, Cujo, before you go, I want to see. In the 90s, who would you say? Like, cause we do like kind of like current, you know, rappers from the 90s. Who would you say? Mm-hmm. Would have
we got the best flow in the 90s?
Yeah.
Lloyd James.
Late 80s, early 90s. You know that flow. That brother was still pissing on himself. Nah, come on, man.
That
brother was pissing on himself.
Them niggas, that flow they had, fire. Big of a planet. Fired. I fuck with them niggas' flows, bro.
That's
just different, man. That's
90s
shit for me.
That's
90s
shit? Okay.
I put Special A. I put Rakim.
Crunchy Black has the worst flow ever.
What? No, hold on, Phil. We ain't got that yet. Hold on. What would you say about Busta? What would y'all say about Busta? Busta
definitely got one of the best flows ever, for sure.
It's
so complicated. It's good though. It's fire.
I was gonna go. Can y'all hear me?
Go ahead.
Not 90s bag. I would say I'm gonna go Snoop. I'm gonna go AZ.
Mello. Yeah, who y'all say AZ?
I'm gonna go Busy Bone.
Is it the voice, Thanos? Is it the voice?
Somebody in here that's gonna take y'all, that's gonna catch y'all off. But I thought he was a flow master, man. Shout out Project Pat, man.
Oh yeah,
oh yeah.
That's Cujo man right there. Cujo man. Cujo just laid a smack down.
He didn't say like the craziest stuff, but he had a lot of different pockets. Mm-hmm. That he got into, I thought he was dope.
Yeah, man, he was flowing on that Take the Charge, man. I was listening, I was like, God damn, this brother going off, man.
Oh, Method Man.
I actually went listen to that song after that episode. Method?
Big had a fire flow too, man. He had a
Raekwon too. Raekwon's right beneath him.
Yeah, I agree.
I feel like they were saying, because sometimes Raekwon just, if you listen to the Triumph song, it's kind of hard to choose who had the best flow.
I mean, nowadays, it's just sick, though. But.
Ghostface got a dope flow, too. It's just that the brother did.
Yeah, Ghost.
And whatever, man. Like,
he tells stories, and he make it sound like he say whatever. That's what it is.
Gold-plated wallabies and hollabies and dollar D's. Like, at this point, you're making up words, brother. Like,
So let me say this. We were talking about. We can say like most of these artists are B tier artists, C, B tier. So can y'all explain to me like most, because we say they're not mainstream. So can y'all explain to me why? If we consider these brothers like the best flow, you know, have the best flow, the best, you know, raps and shit or whatever, why are they not the top niggas? Like, why are we putting people
most
who
we mentioned are top niggas, though? I mean, you know what I'm saying? Okay. Like, AZ at one point, you know, Nas, like, these are definitely top of the line.
I heard a lot of B and C tier niggas, though, Cujo. Come on, bro. Yeah, like, bro.
Influenced. You know, these niggas flow behind the scenes, you know what I'm saying? Like,
okay,
this dude don't get brought up enough. For example, a tragedy, Gaddafi, right? He was the main reason why he started the group Capone and Noriega, but inspired. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he inspired other rappers. Like, he inspired most rappers in Queens. That would be considered their big homie, and he has a dope flow. Very B tier, C tier type rapper. He was also part of the Juice Crew and shit with Rakim. I think who else? Was it? MC Shan was in that group. Big Daddy Kane. Like, bro, been around for a minute, but you know, he had a really dope flow, and you know, he went on to he basically inspired most of Queens rappers, like Nori, Prodigy, Havoc. Like, he was pretty much the predecessor to them niggas. Like, Coogee Rap is in that same bag too, where he B tier, C tier, but he inspired a lot of niggas with that flow. You know what I'm saying? Like, the double time shit that we started seeing. Like, Hov started to emulate that shit after.
I'm glad that's done now.
Daz Effects was on that type of timing too. Nah, that shit was fire. I'm not gonna lie, that was my favorite era. I love that flow. I don't know what you're talking about.
Double time?
Hell yeah, that shit was fire, man.
Oh, I'm so over it, man.
Nah, you bugging for that. That's why one of my favorite rappers ever, like Herb. Like, when I first listened to Herb, I was like, yo, this reminds me of like 90s Nas or something. Like, sometimes that's maybe cramming a lot of words together, you know what I'm saying, to the point where
he it's used kind to be offbeat. Like, it's flowing. Yeah,
it's really
now he's way better.
I feel like the Joy Badass and the Pro Era group, they all can really flow. Like, you know what I'm saying, especially Capital Steve. So I feel like they all can really
cool
rap.
I feel like he wasn't really like a great rapper to me, but he rest in peace. You know, I'm not trying to slander him.
Yeah, you about to get busy. I heard your voice. About to
and now we're going to get to the worst flows, man. We're going to get to the worst flows now. I already have
Shit. God. Here, let me light my blunt up. Let me light my blunt up. Like Wayne used to do in the studio. Hold up, here.
Ever.
You know, Wayne used to do the studio.
M&M's flow. Crunchy Black.
Hold up.
I got M&M's flow from like 07 to 20 till now, actually. Till like 07 to 2015.
That brother's a clone. That brother clone. Go ahead.
Yeah, Eminem flow nasty. Yeah, I don't like it no more.
That brother been clone for a minute, man.
He used to be simple and like it was a lot more punchy. Like now, in like
it was a lot more bar heavy.
08-10, like that's not bar heavy, bro. That shit is ass. What he just
goes. Yeah, I'm saying the shit he's doing now is just more rappity rap. But his earlier stuff was dope. It was like you said, a little bit more punchy, a little bit more bar heavy. Like, one of my favorite lines from him was like, "What he said, we form like Voltrons, and I'm gonna blast you with my shoulder missiles." I'm Slady. Eminem was the old initial.
My bum is on my lip. Like, what was that? Go ahead, Cujo.
He was like you said, but that's your point, Moran. He used to rap back in the day. He was a lot more bar heavy, but now this
rap. Yeah,
now with my bum is on his lip. Nah.
It was either happening. Like, no, it's not gonna work. No, it's not working.
What do you say? This is lyrical combat, gentlemen. Hold your pistols. back with that.
His palms are sweaty.
Yeah.
Huh? His palms are sweaty.
Go back and listen to that.
His palms are sweaty.
Go back.
His paws is sweaty.
What we doing with Silk the Shocker, man?
Oh shit! Oh, man. Let's go.
Right to it.
Let's go, bro. Innovator, bro.
Yeah, he innovator, but he innovated.
Yeah, bro, he innovated. He innovated the world 30 years later, bro. Because I hear a lot of brothers that's off beat right now, bro, and niggas be playing to hear me something. That's fire.
I hang with niggas. Nah, we not
doing
niggas,
that. Did you ever listen to that, brother? No, bro, stop. You had to pick between Silk and Baby, bro. Like who has between Silk and Baby? Who would you feel between Silk and Baby? Who would you?
Nah, Silk is the worst.
He's worse than Baby?
He's worse than Baby. Yes.
Oh, okay. Go ahead.
Silk is way worse than Baby. Baby
is terrible too.
He's terrible, yes, but at least he had a little flaw. At least he said some shit.
He said some shit.
Right, he said some shit.
Y'all better get mad when I say this, but
And
Black Compass, they had a Currency versus Maxi battle, and it was like two songs that I was never a Maxi fan. I respected him because other people respected him. He had got certain lyrics here and there, but I really don't think I'm not the worst, but I really don't have a worst. It's a lot of niggas I like, so he's just one free person I pick out. Like his flow too much and shit like that. I'm still thinking like, oh, the worst. I really can't think. If it's trash, I'm gonna leave you alone, nigga. I'll probably forget what your name is for real. I'm really thinking, like, that's why I'm just letting y'all spit y'all shit. Like, I can't really think.
Hey, who got a real bad flow, who was kind of popular for a little bit? That nigga Riff Raff. That nigga flow horrible.
That's Lil B.
Riff Raff, Lil B. They flows is horrible. They flows is terrible. But
Lil B was ahead of his time.
Only shit I fuck with Riff Raff knew that nigga said. What that nigga said? To win and watch out. I didn't came down. I was like, okay, yo, I ain't fucking with this. All the other shit he got. Taraka, basura. Trinash, throw that away. Throw it away.
I got y'all in a minute, man. Y'all keep naming artists. I feel like you got to turn that bullet. Be around it.
Country Black.
Country Black is terrible.
I think Country was fire to me on some songs, bro. Like I don't think
it's so. His shit worked on some songs, but not all the songs. It worked like that.
Like, wouldn't he be like what the top three members in 3-6 Mob, like just off of notoriety? Like, if you knew a member out of 3-6 Mob, like Country Black probably would be what? Which third person you name, maybe? Yeah?
No, no way.
No way? You will name Jam Master Jay.
No, you got DJ Paul.
DJ Paul. I said Jam Master Jay. Hold on, I said Jam Master Jay. I'm tripping.
Project Pat. Gangsta
Boo.
What's that girl? Gangsta Boo just died.
Yeah, we said Boo.
Gangsta Boo.
Pat.
You don't want maybe.
Yo, so Woody would be what?
That's before the fifth? I'm before Country.
Okay. That's fair. Yep.
Y'all can hear me?
I forgot about Fat Pat. I'm not gonna lie. I forgot about Fat Pat. I was just thinking about, you know.
You got. I didn't really like him either. He had some verses, but I feel like you got some duty in it. Like, yeah, you got. Yeah. You got out of here.
I'm not gonna lie, bro. I hated like when the baby first came out, bro. I hated that flow. Like,
I'm packing the mail.
Let's go. And my girl, the baby, bro.
The baby.
My girl was working for USPS at the time, so she heard the song and she liked it. Then she brought that shit to me. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, this nigga, it sound like he talk. Bro, that shit was cringy every time she put it on, bro. I'm not gonna lie. It had to grow on me. I'm not gonna lie. I didn't fuck it at first. I like the song now, though, by the best. I gotta honest. I like it now, but at that time, I hated that nigga Flow, bro. Oh my God.
It was probably because that was the first song you heard, and that was a
massive
song.
Yeah, I hated that.
It wasn't that. I wasn't listening. My homie spit on me. The shit before. So I'm like, oh, this is how this nigga flowing. And when he had that song, I'm like, it's fire, but it ain't better than the other ones I've heard before. Like, you know what I'm saying? So you heard a mainstream song the first time you heard it, so I can understand.
Yeah. That shit was cringy.
I'm going to go ahead and nominate this brother, man. And I'm going to read these lyrics, man.
No respect. Hello.
On the playback is terrible, man. Nelly's flow is terrible, man. Like
who?
Nelly.
That brother was on Molly not too long ago, man. That brother was on Molly on stage, man. Like I don't know.
Nah, let me read these lyrics, man. The way that this brother was rapping.
Cujo, don't do this.
The whole St. Lunatics was breaking the lyrics up, though, Cujo. That's not all his fault, though, Cujo. At least they all of them was giving Nelly verses and shit or whatever, bro. So that's not all his fault, bro. Like, we can't do that.
Yeah, man.
What'd he say?
Y'all know the song, man. Hot in here. The brother said, I was like, good gracious, ass is bodacious. Trying to stay patient.
It all rhymed, Cujo. It all rhymed.
He's from the Midwest. You don't got to defend
this. Bro, go ahead.
Let me read the lyrics, man.
God damn.
Come on, man. The brother's terrible, man.
Fire-ass party, bro.
Where was that part where he was like, well, let me go through this shit, man. It was one part that was super cringe, man. I'm trying to rap like this nigga, man. It's just too funny, man. The flow.
Hello, what was the last part? You said ass is bodacious.
Yeah, bodacious. Yeah.
But I'm trying to look for a specific part in the song. Just breathe it out.
But this is the Jersey era, though, Phil. Understand that, too. This is the era we play in Jersey. This is the Jersey era. Right here, where we at right here. The Jersey era.
Why you want to judge this brother off a platinum hit? What are we doing? What are judge the brother off the platinum hit, though?
What album was it? Was that on Nellyville? I think it was on the first album. Was it on Nellyville?
Nah, that was the second album. It was the second album. Nellyville. Yeah. That's another one.
And I agree with that. That album was also ass, man, by the way.
Nellyville?
Nellyville was aight.
That's 2003.
Read the rest of the
please. I got a man with a pole in the basement. I'm just kidding, like Jason.
Okay.
Huh? Kicking it like.
Unless you gonna do it? Unless you gonna do it.
Come on,
unless
man.
Unless you gonna do it, Lucci.
The beat break down and everything, Phil. Like, come on, bro.
Right.
Yeah, like, come on, man. We not doing it.
Everybody in the club said, unless you gonna do it. Boom. Beat drop. Right back into it.
Let me finish, Phil. He said,
okay, my bad.
Because you got to think about cutting in restrooms. Like, what?
Huh? Hold on. Read that again. What the fuck did you just say?
Keep going.
Niggas says tattoos is hilarious, man. Oh my God, man. Where the lyric at? Let me find the shit.
Come on, man. Cujo, I can't jack that, bro. Not saying that Nelly had one of the worst flows. Are we talking about lyrics or are we talking about flows right now, bro? Because
whoa, man. You see, I did the whole flow. Unless you go do it, shit was powerful.
Nothing up my sleeve and no teasing.
Come on, man. Keep going.
You got it down. Keep going.
I need you to get it.
Keep going.
Get that man with he asking for.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Cause he feel like busting loose. That's all.
I feel like busting loose.
Man, my girlfriend had a party, bro. I'm not gonna lie.
I hate what you're doing right now.
I probably would never forget that song, bro.
Eagle on, man. We can rap that.
That's the Jersey era, bro. That's the Jersey era.
50 Cent flow. I'm not gonna lie. 50 Cent flow.
Sound like got shit in his mouth.
But he put out one song though.
Yeah.
Flow is hilarious, man. I gotta do this shit too, man. I'm sorry, man. This shit is hilarious, man. His verse on Beat It Up, man. It's hilarious, man. See if I can find the lyrics to this shit, man. Because the way we rap this shit, oh my God.
What song? Who song?
You remember that Beat It Up joint?
With 50.
From who?
The joint by Love Rant. I beat the pussy up.
That song was powerful at one time. That still can come on and move a room right now. They can shake a room right now, Phil.
Yeah, they just shake the room.
Nah, this nigga 50 Cent.
Ain't too much worried about what this nigga was saying, but what he saying?
What 50 Cent? And you gotta do the accent too.
Yeah, the whole story.
You might bring back some memories. Yeah, what he said?
Mute up, let him do it.
Ain't gotta tell you, see what she did.
Did the nigga pause, slow down, and said, Jesse, dang, enough of niggas can go crazy, man. Do crazy thing. And then go right back to just that bullshit ass fast flow. Get the love of the tell you, get the niggas
digging,
You need to do this every week, dog. You just need to find a nigga flow. And you're like, nah, this nigga, he was bugging. He said the nigga was slow.
Bro, he was really rapping like the first half. Then go slow the shit down. And then go right back to it again. All right, man. Then the last part, then you can make one get it in a major way. I'm lying, man. All right, man. All right, fam.
That shit lazy as hell. Oh my god, that was funny as hell, bro. Look, I don't know if you got any more, but I need more. I say 50 got an interesting flow.
I know he got shot in the face and everything, so it definitely altered. Same shit happened to Ye. Sometimes it worked for 50, and then other times I'm lying, but I think my favorite version of this flow is probably on 21 Questions. You know what I'm saying? Like, I fuck with what he was doing on there. Like, it's very distinct. I just want to feel it, twist the lie.
Why do you sound menacing? Why do you sound menacing on a low chalk, sir? Like,
in the verse, man, fulfill to marry, you still let me dismiss you, you still.
I love you like a fat kid, look kick you inside. You think you smile? All that whole stanza, man.
Like, to the quarter century, get a counter, you can be there, support me mentally. That shit was fire, man.
Yeah, 50, you didn't think of that. I just want to twist and turn that. I love you like a fat kid, little cake. You don't stop, little thing, make you smile. Yeah. Menacing is front of the track, like, nigga, do really do something to you. Nigga really will hurt you over this. Like, stop playing with this nigga.
All right, man.
Nigga, so, 50. I love 50, dog.
Yeah, we gonna get back to this, man. I ain't gonna lie on the band joint, but we gonna go to the next topic. Feel me? Ah, man, it's kind of cringe, man. I'm not gonna lie. It's kind of.
Here we go.
Kind of cringe, man.
Oh Lord.
Kind of cringe, but y'all know what happened with I don't know if y'all know, but the whole Young Miami thing. You know what I'm saying? It's P. Diddy, literally.
Oh my God.
You know what I'm saying? Christ.
Jesus Christ, Cujo. Why you shoot from half court tonight, young? What you on, dog? What you on right now? Why you shoot from half court, G? Why you doing this? Why? I'm crying, G.
Gucci, man, I'm gonna need you to take over for a second, brother. Preoccupied.
Take over for a second. I told this shoe is half court, dog. He's killing it right now.
No.
I'm still laughing, bro. Brother said, people, literally. I'm still in amazement. Brother Kucha is different, dog.
Percy, yeah. I don't know. It don't matter. We got the topic, so. I mean, we're not doing Batman? All right. This is the topic, then. We're talking about Young Miami. What's up?
I said we also gonna bring this back next. Next Friday too. Sophisticated Sippers. Go ahead.
But this was your topic, right?
Yo.
Yeah, you good?
You good? So, well, we gonna say that one for the Sophisticated Sippers, or
no? We gonna revisit. We just gonna revisit that. Let's do it.
Pause. Just wanted to make sure. You know what I'm saying?
Here comes it.
I'm not going to lie, man. Young Miami is, I salute her, man. Salute her success with the podcast and everything. Not even really the podcast. You know, the show on Revolt and everything. It's pretty dope, but, you know, I don't know, man. Sometimes Sister gets on there and kind of a little too revealing about certain shit, man. So, I guess she had an interview with, you know, Trina, you know what I'm saying? And they're playing it like a little game or whatever, you know? And she asked what her fantasy is, you know, things that she likes. And she says she like getting, you know, peed on, you know?
This is a week after Kevin Gates went up there and said he drinks pee.
Yeah. So, you know, he go ahead, bro. I'm just let me get my thoughts together, bro. Go ahead, bro. What's going on? Do y'all look at her different now? Like, since we know she like niggas, like niggas are piss on her? Like, what's
going on? Well, I'm gonna say something about Kevin Gates drinking pee.
Yeah, that's nasty. That's just my that's,
hold on. I'm gonna say something though because when I was watching Oprah back in the day, Dr. Oz was on that bitch. He was like, "Yo, if you was struggling, if you in the desert, stop it. Thirsty,
my grandpa did that. That's not bro. They had to do that
on
Better Call Saul. They had to drink pee, bro.
I heard multiple times drinking your pee could be healthy. It sound nasty as fuck, but then I'm not even surprised Kevin Gates even said that. So
bro,
like,
he said he drank somebody else's.
Yeah, it don't matter. It's Kevin Gates. I mean, this nigga already trying to be on some healthy shit. He might think it's healthy. Kevin say he say wild shit. Now let's get back to this Trina shit or whatever. Who like being pissed on? Because I ain't even think she like being pissed on.
Amen.
And that's dangerous.
Hello? I mean, I've heard. I'm not even gonna say no.
Go ahead. We can get cringy.
Nah, it's been told to me that they're just like that. It just feels warm.
Oh, man. What? Come on, brother. I'm not letting you get away with that, man. That was a ridiculous pause right there, brother.
My bad.
Nah, it's all good. Nah, man. Golden showers, as they say, man, kind of been a thing for a couple years now. You know what I'm saying? I don't really understand the appeal of it, but there's some women that like that shit, man. You know, I don't know.
Yeah, but then if you got thick, that's kind of nasty though too, because if it's golden, that means you ain't drinking. You might not be drinking a lot of water, because when you drink water, your shit ain't gold. It ain't that yellow tint. You know what I mean? You drink a lot of pop, and shit. You know, juice.
Sometimes it's green.
Oh no, bro! What the fuck is that? Green?
No, say that again. I missed that. What you said?
So sometimes it's green.
What's green?
Sometimes it's green though.
Piss?
I never seen no green pee.
Nah, nigga, you need to go to the doctor ASAP. If that piss green, you need to go to the doctor. No, you know what? He's not lying.
Because if you take
all-purpose vitamins, like your shit will come out green. I'm not gonna lie. I got some. He's not lying. Cause I thought something.
Pause and listen. I mean, Loaded Lux shit probably pee green because he always eating.
What the?
That nigga
hell?
Eating. He be eating sea moss and everything. That nigga talking about vitamins. If vitamins do that, and somebody healthy. I've never seen or heard about green piss.
I'm not gonna lie. Every woman got different kinks, man. Some are more honest about
it. Every woman got different
kinks.
It's women out there that like eating dudes' booties.
We can give
a nigga pass eating a girl.
Like, she pulling you down, you heard me? Like, she pulling you down, like she whipping you down. Yeah, like, nigga, come here. Like, come here. What you running for? Like, nah, this shit
get that about myself. So, what's wrong with you guys that you think that?
You gotta chill, bro.
No, no, Robbie said he got a friend that PO girls, bro. No, like,
Robbie, you call hold them heroes, up. Too. Like,
my bro said he got a friend that pee on girls.
There
bro.
Should be a flag for them, like the red and blue striped flag.
Robbie, you can tell it's
no.
Where's Mimi, bro?
I don't know what it is.
Find out Mimi ate a boo man, but that
go ahead, Cujo. Go ahead, bro.
I don't know what it is specifically about it that women like, or at least Young Miami like. Maybe it's the way the shit streams down. I don't know, man.
I'm gonna say this, bro. Like, in the streets, that's very disrespectful. If a nigga said, nigga, I'll beat the shit out of you and piss on you. Like, that's very disrespectful.
Right.
Pissing
yeah,
on you, like, bro.
Shit.
Like, when you piss, like, so I'm trying to figure out, like, the mentality to let, for a woman to let a man actually piss
the
on
thing
her.
Is, bro, Lucci, what we it's, consider disrespectful, bro, some women like in bed.
Well, I think I'm gonna
say hold up. I'm trying to say this. My last bar. Who? I mean, when you're having sex, when you involve in sexual activities, like, bro. To piss is probably one of the last things you want to do to stop doing what you're doing. So for a nigga
to stop. Oh my god.
Bro, if you fucking something, you gotta go piss, bro. Like that shit, like that's the worst feeling in the world.
Bro,
like one of the worst feelings
in
sex besides a bitch hitting you with her teeth.
The mentality for a woman is when a girl get peed on, like girls, like when you fucking a girl, they like, you know, they feel submissive. They like the dominant. So to them, maybe getting peed on, it's like, okay, this is
he got
it over me. You know, he's dead.
Man,
he hit me with the yellow piss, the shit that looked like the tea, the lifting tea. You got the lifting tea piss?
What if it's the green pee?
The lifting tea.
Sometimes it's brown. Go to the doctor, bro. Yeah, if it's brown, that's doozy,
yeah,
bro.
Just go to your doctor, bro. Like, just go ahead on again.
There's some
like,
women and we ain't gonna do that because I remember the two girls in the cup. Remember that shit? These bitches out here different. That was chocolate, bro. I've never seen that video before, bro.
I've heard about it, brother gave me some. No, you're not gonna scream, you motherfucking thing. I'm not gonna be here because I just heard what it was about, but I've never seen that video. I still haven't seen it.
Overall, right? Like this seems to be like it's like a psychological thing for certain women. Like when they like her, like whether it's being slapped, like literally slapped in the face. Some women like that.
Yeah.
Some women like being faint till the ass is red and shit. Like it's just a certain thing that, you know, saying they like, that might stimulate them for whatever reason, bro. Like I don't know, man. Everybody got some type of shit, bro, where it's like they might not be open about it, but if you ask, you want to try it with them, then they're gonna be super open about it.
Is that
a dude on YouTube going on?
I don't lie. I might slap a bit, man. I've done it before.
I'm gonna tell you something. Bitches be lying. I seen a dude on YouTube go around. I forgot what city and he did. Most of the city said, "Can I eat your ass?" And then he seen what the girls say. A lot of girls was like, "Yeah, I'll let him do it." Some girls like, "Nah, I won't do that shit. I don't do that." I'm like, "These bitches is capping."
I think I see that video.
A lot of girls really do say they don't do that shit, and then you find out, yeah, they do that.
But peeing though, body bags, like, is that the same thing as a nigga being like, bro, I like to eat bitches on their period?
It's close, but not really, because I don't really think it's close because you can, a girl can be on her period and then you cannot get blood in your mouth, probably just lick her clit or some shit, but like pissing is deliberately like, yeah, bitch, I'm about to pee on you. She don't know if it's gonna be hot, gold, she just know piss is coming out.
Gym and ready to just let it off.
Yeah, hold on, this is the thing. You know, when you pee as men, I just thought about this. I thought it's just getting pissed on. So if he peeing on her and these girls get peed on, they do it. They hitting them with the shake too. Like, you know, when you gotta shake the shit off, they get hit with the shake.
Like, as if that was the last of your bag.
Do they be like, baby, go ahead, shake that shit on me? You done?
Yeah, like, I would.
Let me hear Black. I want to hear what Black got to say, because Black ain't got a chance. I want to hear what you got. But this Miami shit, young Miami, whatever it is.
I got shit for you, dog. Shit nasty, man. That shit foul, dog. Like, I don't like that, man. Like, even just like, even if like you kind of switch the roles, like, I'd be disgusted if it felt like she could like get that involved type of shit. Like, oh, let me just like kind of like just start pissing. Like, if we fucking and shit, like. The bitch just start pissing, like, I'm out of there, dog. Like, that shit. Do niggas kind of consider that to be like within like the same type of realm, or like, because I'm fine with bitch squirting.
I'm fine with squirting, because squirting, you got to make a bitch squirt. Yeah, you see what I'm saying? You can't just, but pissing is different. Like, nah, let me piss. No, squirting is like, that gotta happen. You gotta, that's trial and error right there. You gotta put in work to even get that to happen. But they'd be like, oh, I just pissed on you. But I'm like, girl, I have to, this ain't just really piss. This your wetness. I gotta make you, you gotta get to this point. But
Go ahead, Cujo.
Really, like, know what squirt is considered, but it is like basically diluted. It has like a completely different smell, like everything to it, and it's very clear. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but
let me ask you something. Isn't the nigga just as weird as the fucking female who love to piss on a female? Wouldn't the nigga be considered just as weird as her? No.
I mean, what would you do?
Bro,
let's say if you fuck Lisa Ann. Let's say Lisa Ann coming to you. I want to fuck you, Lucci. But you got to piss on me. Lisa Ann,
I'm doing it.
I wouldn't want to deal with, just me personally, I wouldn't want to deal with a female that is willing to pissed on. Like, that would turn me off. Like, bitch, like, you really to go that to that extent? Like, bitch, like, what? Like, have y'all ever dealt with a female where you'd be like, nah, this bitch is too freaky. This too freaky for me right here. I can't fuck. Like that. Nah, Cujo, okay. I gotta get out of this bitch.
I've seen them bitches, and there's definitely sometimes I've like passed by a bitch and it's like, oh, you extra freaky. I'm good on that. Like,
You can turn down some shit from a bitch being too freaky, man. Like if you not a hard up nigga behind no pussy or nothing like that. If you used to getting pussy,
you know it's crazy though, because it's supposed to be recommended. You're supposed to pee before and after sex. So where did you find time to do that shit, like,
bro? That's what I'm trying to figure. That's my question.
Do it, and then you go to the bathroom and just.
Hold on. I'm confused.
I'm confused.
Like a motherfucker.
Hitting the bitches with the morning piss.
Because I'm trying to figure, like I told y'all, bro, to me, having to piss during sex is one of the most. I hate it, son. Like, cause it, you know, it stops everything. So for a nigga to be like, I'm fucking while I'm having sex, and I didn't build my shit up to piss. Like, how do you get past trying to bust a nut to build up to piss.
You just practice, bro. Like,
it's kind of come on, bro. Like that, yeah, that nigga weird, man. That's
you got to complete the mission. Why are you?
But how do you piss? Like, how do you feel? Like, piss is the farthest thing from your mind. Like, no nigga don't want to stop what they're doing to go piss in the bathroom. So,
and then like, you gotta nigga, think, if you go to pee what on the a fuck? Girl, like, you can't.
If it's germ before or after, that's what I need. I need more information on this. Is this germ before or after sex? Because if it's during sex, like after,
I think it's during, it can't be during.
But if I really got to stop what I'm doing to like go take a piss and like I'm gonna do that shit. Like I'm not gonna even risk like. That's a fact. That shit. Like,
yeah. Okay.
Happening. Like, won't stop. Yeah, and, like, that's go ahead, it. Take care of business and then get back to business.
Yeah. Okay.
I feel like they do it before, or like I feel like sometimes they might not have sex. They just want to be peed on, or like being pee in my mouth. Nah. Or they got. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, I think that's what it is. Cause like when you having sex, when did you have a time like me? It's like you gotta think. You fucking right, and then you gotta want that shit. Oh, pee on me. You gotta get up and go to the bathroom. You gonna if you fucking in the bed, big and full of piss and
piss
your
like,
carpet,
bro. So can we all agree that P Diddy is pissing on? Well, I call it bro. P Diddy. P Diddy is pissing on this one.
Nah, it's probably
go
not
ahead,
him.
Cujo, go
it's
ahead,
probably
Cujo.
Not him.
Go ahead, bro. I'm good.
Somebody else.
It probably happened.
That's some freaky Ziggy would do.
You think it, man? Diddy got deodorants and shit in his drawers, bro.
I'm
gonna say that because they seen deodorants and shit in Diddy drawers and shit. So I'm pretty sure he on some other shit. Yeah.
Right
now, if asked to,
I don't think it's him.
Two, I shall deliver.
You don't think it's him, Phil?
I don't think it's him.
I don't know if it's him.
He was trending. He was trending after she said that. He was trending on Twitter.
We know what the P stands for now.
Yeah. Ooh.
Piss Diddy.
Piss Diddy. Piss Diddy. Piss Diddy.
Piss Daddy. Piss Daddy. Piss Daddy.
I'm saying that.
Do you think
that's
she...
crazy? Pause.
That's what she called him. They be calling him Piss Daddy. Yeah. That's the name now.
Do you think he get golden shower back? Do he let her piss on him?
Man, what?
How are we supposed to know?
Yeah, I'm at bro. Like we dealing with mentalities. We dealing with
the closest to P. A brother gonna get his squirt, man. That's it.
Okay,
I ain't right. Letting nobody. I gotta go to the bathroom. Go to the fucking bathroom.
Man, you better go to the fucking bathroom because you're about to do this
just
right.
Open wide.
Man, nah. Okay, next. Go ahead, Cujo. Transition, bro. We out of here, bro. Yeah, y'all, hey, y'all tune in Friday, bro. We gonna get crazy Friday. We gonna get crazy. We gonna get real crazy Friday.
That was
go
wild,
ahead.
Yeah, definitely
went
crazy.
Robbie been tripping.
Yeah,
I
have to either. Go ahead, Cujo. Go ahead, bro.
Oh, yeah. I'm saying that's what you say is what I'm saying.
Just 20 minutes, bro. 20
minutes. Oh, okay. Yeah, they probably do that shit. Yeah, okay. That's
crazy.
Yeah, man.
Hey, we gotta all remember this brother Marabi said he got a friend that pees on girls.
Nah, he
I don't know no niggas like that. I don't know no niggas like that. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. Like you, I don't know.
He told me he do this. What? Why is this brother in your circle of people that you consider a friend? I'm gonna ask questions now. In jeopardy right now because you've revealed this information to me. Now I have to ask questions about
why?
You.
Why? Why are you so judgmental?
Why?
Nah.
What you mean?
Hey,
why?
Yeah, hey, let's say that
before. Why with the nigga? Why would I? Are you? So you? No.
Bro, I got a question. Do your homies call you like, I just got done fucking this bitch and I pissed on her?
Like, can you do that? Like, yo, does your homie be like, hey, Rob, you can't, you ain't gonna believe the bitch I pissed on, bro. Oh, like, do he call you?
Nah, he did say, like, yeah. Yeah.
That's crazy.
That's crazy.
He out here wild. He's gonna violate bitches. He's gonna violate.
Me and that young man have to reevaluate our friendship.
I was like, I didn't want to say.
I'm not gonna judge him, bro.
Like, I was like, okay, that's good for you, bro. I was like, all right.
I'm not gonna judge him, but I'm definitely gonna ask more questions because now I have to reevaluate you. I gotta see where you're mentally.
Why?
I gotta see where your mental is now because now this ain't normal behavior. Like, just out here just, hey, I pissed on a bitch. Like, what? Like, what is that? What are you talking about?
Yeah, that's not a common everyday thing.
It's not a common everyday like occurrence.
Just imagine a conversation. No. Just
I don't really.
Imagine the conversation after your homie tells you that. Like, bro, when?
The cleanup. What? You gotta clean
what?
That up.
What you did?
You gotta clean that up.
Like me. If I had a friend, I would question him. But I just be like, okay, you just wanna violate bitches. That's you. I'm still your homie. Long as you ain't out here pissing on
exactly.
bitches, like, you care.
Exactly.
Like, I don't care because there's bitches out here. I had a girl that she told me and she was like, I didn't fucking watch. She said, yeah, that's my cousin on my dad's side. But I'm like, ain't that your cousin? That your cousin? She said, yeah, she's my cousin on my mom's side. So yeah, it's fucking wrong. She said, yeah, and he eat her booty. So I'm like.
We giving Cujo, you know the brother wants to see, he got another classic, but we giving him one of our topics right now. Let that brother transition, man. Go ahead.
Crazy, man.
I'm fine.
20 minutes, Cujo.
Yeah, Brother Thug, man. Brother Thug is
Oh my God.
Brother Thug is
We're not saying free him anymore. We're not saying that.
Listen, man, you know, if y'all not familiar, man, y'all should be. You know what I'm saying? The whole YSL team is locked up. You know, it's been a couple months now. Brothers been ratting. You know what I'm saying? Getting less time. Some brothers got free. Some been threatening folks. You know what I'm saying? All type of shit. There's been a lot going on, man. But apparently... Brother Thug, man, gotta get a perk passed through him, you know, in jail and whatnot, and got caught.
No, in the courtroom.
In the courtroom of all places.
Live on TV. You know? Or live on video.
It was wild, man. So I don't know, man. At this point, we're probably gonna put on extra time for the brother. Maybe he feels like it's over and he's just doing whatever to calm himself down. I don't know at this point, man, but it's getting like blatantly reckless, you know what I'm saying? But
sound like,
I will say, it is crazy though, because they've been basically building up a case on Thug for about 10 years, basically. It is crazy, man, to see everyone damn near around him just fold, man. Like, and it's probably causing him a lot of stress. Like, literally,
he looks 40 now.
Yeah, like it's just like, damn, man, like. You know, the rollout is going to be now. It's like all your ops, they're going to have so much raps now. Like, they got so much material to rap about now. Like, a lot.
That's cool. That's a whole lot of material,
you know.
Is YFN Lucci back?
Nah, he's still locked up. He's locked up for a minute. But, yeah, man, I don't know what's going on with the brother, man. Like, I don't know. I know drugs in prison is it's a thing. You know, it's common.
That was just straight up stupid, man. Like,
yeah, that was just wild,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, that was dumb. Yeah, that was really dumb.
I don't know what he's going to do now, man. But they're definitely going to throw on more time for the brother, man. How many years is he looking at anyway?
life.
Oh, man. Yeah, they're trying to throw leader charge.
Life is what he's looking at. Yes, sir. Yeah. Life.
Yeah, they're trying to throw the gang leader charge on him. I see what they're doing. It kind of reminds me of the brother out of New York, named Rod Diggs, who got locked up for murder, conspiracy, racketeering. Bro was a rapper, though, but, you know, he was outside, too, and, you know, he's considered leader of a gang. Even if you aren't necessarily, if you are a rapper, or you just look like somebody that stands out the most out of everybody, you're going to be considered the leader. That's just how it is. So then they're going to just pile on as many charges as they can on you. And, you know, whether it sticks or not, doesn't really matter. They're trying to just throw you under the jail, unfortunately. So it's sad, man, what's going on, but I can't be mad. I can't sympathize with the brothers. He's making his choices. You know what I'm saying? He went outside. He made them songs. He did what he did. And nobody willing to do the time. So it's on him, man.
I think me personally with that situation, you know, just being in those court situations, I think that what happened in court is the leastest thing he have to worry about, as far as, I mean, you would just label that as trying, as they would label that as you trying to introduce contraband into a facility, you know. But, you know, people who have never been in that situation, I wish Thanos was here to talk, you know, they would think like, oh, it's bad. Nah, it's just like you just trying to fucking get drugs in the fucking jailhouse. They'll label you as, you know, trying to bring contraband into the facility or whatever. So the charge, I mean, it is more time, but compared to what he's already dealing with, that's a slap on the wrist. But the media is actually blowing it up. Oh, he's got this, he got that. He's trying to do this, he's trying to do it. But that's small things to a giant, bro, to be honest with. As far as dealing with what he's dealing with, that's not nothing. Like, motherfuckers get busted for that type of shit every day, fam. But he was just on camera, on TV, and, you know, so that's why it looked bad.
I agree. I definitely agree. I don't know at this point, man. I don't know. Brother Luke, man.
What? Middle Luke.
Nah, you good. Nah, overall, you know, what's going on with Thug is, I can't really say it's a foul situation or a messed up situation, as I said. They've been building the case for years.
Did it to himself.
You know, all of them did, really. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You do the crime, you gotta do the time, you know.
Except for Gunna.
You know, I mean, hey.
Now you can get out of it, I guess. I don't know.
I mean, yeah, some of them did, you know, with the ratting. But
y'all see what Flex said?
No, what you talking about? Funk Master Flex?
Yeah.
Said about who?
He said, since everybody's snitching anyway, he's gonna play Gunna in 6ix9ine music.
Oh man,
that's weird.
Like, that is, yeah.
That don't justify it. Like, that don't make, just because everybody mentioned that, just makes them look bad. That don't mean it's just cool to play their music now.
Oh, man. Let me find the post.
Especially if you stood on that previously, it's like, well, what changed with you then? So it's like, just because there's more snitches out here, don't mean it's like it's cool.
Right. I agree.
Open foul. Like, that don't make it cool to just go ahead and keep doing their shit. I don't know. That's to each your own, though. Like, if you really not like a street nigga like that, like, you can, I don't care if you play the music. Like, I personally never really listened to a whole lot of Gunna or like the, or like 6ix9ine and shit. But, you know, I don't have no real drive to like go back and do the shit after they do they homies foul and shit like that in certain situations or whatever. But you big on that, like, I don't get why this changes anything now just because it's more prevalent. Now it's like cool. That doesn't sound really cool to me.
I agree. Yeah, I agree. I don't know. I don't know enough about Gunna outside of rap to determine anything. It's really none of my business, you know. I'm not from Atlanta, so I don't know nothing about that. It is what it is with that, man. I don't know what to say, bro. Brother got himself in trouble, man. That's all I can say. But I ain't gonna lie, brothers, man. We got another.
Look in the chat. One sec. Oh, there you go. That's the post. The update is about him speaking to Jim Jones, who's also never mind. But you know, you see, he said about 6ix9ine.
Yeah.
I'm no longer not. Yeah.
I mean, I guess he has a point to some degree, but I don't know. I don't know, man. Yeah, what was I about to say? Oh yeah. Brother Lucci, you still here?
Huh?
Yeah, I was about to say, after this, you know what I'm saying, we got another cringy movie premiere, by the way. You know what I'm saying? It's a goodie. Maybe some of you seen it already, but it's pretty good, man. We finna roll these movie premieres out practically either every Friday or every other Friday. Get a couple people in here, just, you know, crack jokes, whatever. Get as many cringe moments as you possibly get in. So, what we doing, Lucci? We gonna cut the show out. We gonna, you know what I'm saying? What we doing, brother? Yeah, man. This is a dope episode, man. A dope episode. A lot of cringe, man. A lot of. Yeah. That's a fact. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, sophisticated sippers, man. We're gonna really have more in-depth topics, you know what I'm saying? Brothers, you know, celebrating B-Days, and you know, some brothers out of town right now, so we had to do what we had to do for the time being. It's all good, you know what I'm saying? But tune in next week, you know what I'm saying? I'm definitely gonna bring up that Batman joint again. I'm gonna rehash the flow comment. I mean, not the flow comment, the flow topic again. You know what I'm saying? And yeah, man, we're going to be around, though, man. Is we podding, though, man? We out.